In this lesson, we will see what is the typical NLP pipeline while processing text data. So this is the overall pipeline for working with text data. So let's understand them one by one. So first we have raw data that's present in the data set. So while working with this SMS spam collection data set, this is the raw data, text data that we have. So in this step, the Python does not understand any distinction between words. So what it sees is just a stream of characters. And for it, all the characters are same. So this step is not very useful for working with Python. So first, we need to convert it to individual words. So this we call tokenization. So for example, if I have a sentence, input text is I am teaching NLP in Python. So all the characters mean the same to Python, even this space here, or there is a full stop here, and here is a double space. So all these characters are similar to it. So when we tokenize it, we convert it to a list which will consist of I am teaching NLP in Python. So this is a list of words. So this we call tokenization. So this way we will tell the model what to look at. So you should not look at characters, but these characters, I have grouped them into words. So this is one word, this is another word. But still, some words may be more important than the other words. But Python doesn't know yet which word is more important. It just sees a list of words, and for it, all the words are similar. Like in this step, all the characters were similar. So we need more processing on it. So this we will call cleaning. So we will clean the text. So the next step is text cleaning. And what it does is that we will remove the stop words. So stop words are the words which are just connecting the words to form a meaningful sentence. For example, here we can remove I, am, and in. So now we will be left with teaching NLP and Python. So we have reduced this to this small list because these are more important words and convey the text context that is present in this sentence. So this I, am, and in, these can be present in much more frequently in many sentences, and these are just connectors and these does not add too much to the context that the machine wants to understand. So we get rid of those stop words or punctuations, and then we further do cleaning involves. So we have removed stop words and we can also get rid of these ing and other things. So this is called stemming. So what it means is that like teaching, teaches, teachers, all these will be converted to their root words, which is teach, and then NLP, and then Python. So this is the result of cleaning step. We can do other things also in cleaning. Now next is that, so once we have cleaned data, still it's not ready to be fed to the model because model does not understand any machine learning algorithm does not understand text data. It works on numeric data. So we need to convert this text to number. Or rather, this is the text and the output is number. So this is called vectorization. So vectorization can involve many techniques. So some of the popular techniques for vectorization are like word to vec. Then we have bag of words. Then we have TF, IDF. It means term frequency, inverse document frequency. So for example, in order to convert the words to numbers, you can iterate through your entire text data after the text has been cleaned. So obviously it will not contain the stop words or punctuation, and we would have also a stemmed data, so it will just contain a list of words, word 2, word 3. And if this word 2 has occurred in, let's say, next sentence also, then we will not include it. So then we can create a list of unique words irrespective of their order, and then we can assign an index to them, like 0, 1, 2. So if this entire list has 3 words, then it will have 0, 1, 2. And in order to represent any sentence, like there is a sentence called teach and word 3, the clean version of that text is this teach and word 3, then its representation will be 1, 0, 1, because 1 means teach is present, 0 means word 2 is not present here, and 1 means word 3 is present. So this is just one representation. There can be other representation, like we can take a matrix and each row corresponds to a given sentence and each column corresponds to a word. Similarly, there can be other representation. We will see more of it in the further lessons on vectorization. So once we have converted our text data to numeric representation, we are ready to feed it to our ML algorithm. So in this step, we will feed in the text data and also the corresponding level, like spam or ham. So we will feed in that this number represents spam. This number, which is another sentence, this represents ham, and so on. We will feed in multiple, and this spam or ham will also be labels. So these can be 0, 1, 2, depending on how many levels we are working with. So it can mean 0. So this set of numbers means 0. This set of numbers means 1. So we are ready to feed in lots of such cleaned data, converted cleaned and vectorized data to our algorithm, to the model. And when we feed in sufficient number of such data, our model will be trained, and then we can test on newer data to see whether the model works correctly or not, or does it need more training. And once we are done with that training and our model is ready, we are ready for doing further a test on that using a spam filter. So our model is ready and we can deploy it for production, and it can be used for real life prediction of whether the email is spam or not. So this was the entire work pipeline for working with text data. For other type of data, it may vary slightly, but the concept will remain the same. So I hope you enjoyed the lesson. See you in the next lesson. Thank you.